My name is Angelia Simbolon, and I'm a student of English Department 2020 of Riau University with student register number 2005112478. And this video is for my final task of micro teaching lesson. Enjoy it! Okay, good morning, students! How are you this morning? Are you happy? Good! Have you had your breakfast? Good! So guys, are you ready with our class today? Okay, if you're ready, please tidy up your desk, please. Good then. Okay, I'll call your name one by one. And if you're here, raise your hand and say presence, miss. Alright? Aisha Mutiara? Anissa Mukaroma? Firdaus Gaho? Gabriela Teresia Damani? Tresia Margaret Panggabean? Where is Tresia, guys? Tresia, see? I'm sad to hear that. I wish she gets well really soon. Okay, Chairman, please guide our prayer in this morning. Okay, thank you, Chairman. Okay, students, now I want to ask you, have you already understood our lesson last week? So, Gabby, what is our topic lesson last week? Yes, present tense, continuous tense, and the last one is past tense. Okay, good. Please give applause for Gabby, guys. Okay, so now I want to show you a picture of, I don't know what is this. Can you guess it, please? Yes, right. This is Borobudur Temple. So, this picture is a clue for our lesson today. Can you guess what is our topic today? No one knows? Okay guys, so today we will learn about descriptive text. Descriptive text, yes. So have you ever learned about descriptive text before? I think you already, right? But you forget it. It's okay. Can you guess what's the purpose of learning about descriptive text? No one know? Okay, I'll tell you. So the purpose we learned about descriptive text and why descriptive text is so important to learn, because in descriptive text, if we can understand about descriptive text, we can understand how to describe something like animals or people or person and maybe place, yes, anything. We can describe anything. Alright, so it's the purpose of our lesson today. So now guys, I want to show you some example of descriptive text. Here it is. The first one is the descriptive text about the Borobudur Temple. And the second is the descriptive text about Bali Island. So now I will give you some minutes to read this descriptive text, okay? Okay, have you finished? So I want to ask you, what is the purpose of this text? Yes, Anissa? Yes, good. The purpose is to describe about Borobudur Temple. Right, good. Give a pause to Anissa, please. Okay, before we start and we enter to our lesson here, I will give you a yell. So the yell is like, if me say, students, you will answer, hey yo miss, like that. Can you guys? Okay, now I will explain about descriptive text. The first one is the definition. So the definition of descriptive text is a text which say what a person or a thing is like, or to describe a person, an animal, a plant, or place, and anything else. So guys, next is the purpose of descriptive text. Descriptive text has two purposes. There are, the first one is to describe person, thing, or place in specific, and the second is to describe a particular person, thing, or place. So next is about the generic structure of descriptive text. Anyone know what is the generic structure of descriptive text? No one know? Okay, I'll explain. So descriptive text has two generic structures. The first one is identification, and the second one is description. What's the meaning of identification and in descriptive text? In descriptive text, identification contains about the introduction of a person, place, animal, or object that will describe. The description is contains a description of something such as animal, things, person, or place by describing its features, forms, colors, or anything related to the writer described. Okay, the last part is about the language feature of the descriptive text. Descriptive text has four the language feature. There are specific participants, the use of the adjective, the use of simple present tense, and the action verb. So guys, can you guess descriptive text is used what pattern? Yes. Good job, Aisha. Descriptive text is used the simple present tense. What are the language features of the descriptive text? The first one is specific participants. This has meaning, has a certain object, is not common and unique or only one. Can you give the example, please? Yes, Anissa. Good job. Give applause to Anissa, please. The second is the use of the adjective. An adjective to clarify the noun. Can you give the example, please, Gaby? Okay, good. And the third is the use of simple present tense. So the sentence pattern used in simple present tense because it tells the fact of the object described. And the last one is action verb. So can you guess the language feature number 4? Action verb. Yes, Aisha? Yes, right. That's so an activity example. Okay, good. Very good. Give applause for all of you guys. After learn about the generic structure of descriptive text, can you guess the generic structure of the Borobudur temple? Yes, so the first paragraph is the identification, and the second and the third paragraphs is the description part. And it's same for the Bali Island. Can you guess it? Okay, Gaby. So the first paragraph is what? Yes, you're right. And Anissa, the second paragraph is for what? Okay, good. And Aisha, the last paragraph is for what? Okay, good job, guys. Students, are you sleepy? Are you ready for the next exercise? Or maybe we gonna take an ice breaking first? Okay, let's have an ice breaking first. Okay.
I got to push pineapple, shake the tree. I got to push pineapple, grind coffee. To the left, to the right, jump up and down onto the knees. Come and dance every night, sing with a hula melody. she was selling pineapple plates. I got to push pineapple, shake the tree. I got to push pineapple like coffee. To the left, to the right, jump up and down until the knees. I'm a nice every night, simple on a melody. I got to push pineapple, shake the tree.
Your understand about the descriptive text. Here I have three cards. Now you make three groups. Okay. This is for the group one. This is for the group two. And this is for the group three. So in the card ada sebuah atau dua kata. Coba dibuka. Oke, sudah. Jadi kata-kata tersebut akan menjadi title atau judul dari descriptive text yang akan kalian buat. Mengerti? If you can write your descriptive text here. Okay. I'll give you 5 to 7 minutes to discuss it and write it, okay? After that, you give it to me. Okay, time's up. Thank you, and thank you guys. Miss akan periksa ini di rumah, tapi sepenglihatan Miss, sepertinya kalian sudah bisa membuat text descriptive yang baik. It's easy, right? Okay, good then. Tapi di sini Miss masih punya beberapa soal untuk kalian kerjakan. Okay, jadi di sini ada dua teks. Yang pertama adalah tentang finis, and the last one is about Natural Bridge National Park. Jadi yang finis ini kalian kerjakan hari ini, dikumpul hari ini juga. Dan yang National Park itu menjadi tugas, oke? Ini. Oke guys, apakah kalian mengalami kesulitan? Any question for the task? No? Okay, I'll read your name one by one and you will answer from number 1 to number 4. Okay, until number 4. Soal pertama dibacakan oleh Gabby. So the answer is C. Yes, right. Give applause for Gabby, please. The second one is Aisha. B. Yes, you're right. The third is for Anissa. Good job, Anissa. Give applause, please, guys. Okay, my lovely students. Good. Okay, sekarang kita ulang kembali ya, supaya lebih paham lagi. The definition of the descriptive text is what? Yes, to describe a person, an animal, things, or anything. Okay, good. Okay, and the generic structure of the descriptive text, there are two. The first one is identification, that contain about introductions of the title or the topic, and the description that describe more details and specific about the topic that you choose. Okay, good job, my lovely students. Give applause for our class, please. Okay, Miss ingin ucapkan terima kasih dan kalian sangat luar biasa untuk kelas hari ini. Di rumah dipelajarin lagi. Semoga minggu depan gak lupa dan seterusnya juga gak lupa. Thank you. Bye-bye. Okay, I think that's all for my test video for my final exam. So, if there's any mistakes, please forgive me, okay? Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.